Let's now try to compare the different means for conditional constructs that we have learned about and try to understand them. Note that all of them are pretty much equivalent to some extent. So we can reproduce an if-else using a hook colon and vice versa. So in this little task, what we will try to do, we will try to compare a value and print some text if a condition is met using all our different constructs. So first of all, what kind of text do we want to print? How about x bigger than 10? And we want to print the truth value, so we do our little comparison first. So x bigger than 10. So this expression gets evaluated to a numerical value and we print out this numerical value. So let's see what this actually prints. So we execute it, it prints 0 because our value was 5. 5 is not bigger than 10, so that means it's false. False is 0. So that's right. So now let's be a bit more verbose, because the user may be confused to see what does 0 and 1 mean, right? So maybe we want to print something like proper text. Say, if the value is bigger than 10, we want to print x is bigger than 10, okay? This we want to print if the value is bigger than 10. So how can we do this? Well, the first easiest way is we use an if condition. So we say if x is bigger than 10, well, we want to print the text x is bigger than 10. So that's not a big deal. So we can do this. We can also say to use the hook colon to do this job. So with the hook colon, we can print some string. This is the format specifier to print a string. And if the string is, for example, x is bigger than 10, we now always print this string in our printf. But now we want to print it only if x is bigger than 10. So we can use our hook colon construct. We can say if x bigger than 10, question mark, that is our condition now. If it's bigger than 10, then we print x is bigger than 10. Otherwise, we print x is smaller than 10. I just print it this way. Okay, so now what will it print? Well, this ternary operator gets evaluated to x is bigger than 10 because our condition is met. And then this string and this address is printed on the left-hand side. So let's compile it and run it, and we get x is smaller than 10 because x is just 5. Let's change x to 15 and rerun our application that you can see that it works. So x is bigger than 10 returns now 1, which means it's true. Our if prints x is bigger than 10, and so the hook colon prints as well x is bigger than 10. So let me be a little bit more verbose here and say this is the output of if and this is the output of hook colon. So now this was a very basic example. How about we include the if, the else part? Okay, so if what happens if x is smaller than 10? We already did this in our printf for the hook column, but we didn't do it for our regular if. So let's expand the solution here. Say if else, to make it else, we have to add the else branch here. So that means if the condition is met, we print this string. Otherwise, we want to print f another string, which is x smaller than 10 in this example. So this will now really result in the same output as our hook colon, as you will see. So In the if else, we get x is bigger than 10. But now let me change x to be 5 again, compile and run it. So we, from the hook colon, we get the output x is smaller than 10. And in the if else, we get also x is smaller than 10. So now we can obviously add further branches and further conditions. Let's say if the value is bigger than 20, we want to say x is bigger than 20. Okay, now we want to print as well if the value is bigger than 20. So how can we do that? Well, with if and else, it's quite easy. We have to copy our condition. So if x is bigger than 20, well, we say x is bigger than 20. Otherwise, so else, if it's not, if x is bigger than 10, we say x is bigger than 10. So if and if else, I think this is pretty much self-explanatory. Let's try it. And we set x to 25, for example. Compile and run. If our if else said x is bigger than 20. So that seems to work. And of course, I can change it to 15. And says x is bigger than 10. But it's not bigger than 20, right? Because it's just 15. Okay. Now, in this case, if you do the if and the else's, you have to always be sure that the order in which you put them is sensible. So because the evaluation starts always with the if, so is this condition met, then we execute all the statements inside this block. And only if this condition is not met, then we go with the else part. Okay, why is that important? So what would have happened, so if we do this wrongly, with the wrong order? Okay, for example, we start with if x is bigger than 10, print x is bigger than 10. Otherwise, if x is bigger than 20, print x is bigger than 20. So this is broken, wrong code, for the reason that this, if this condition is met, we go always in this branch. But that has the direct consequence that this condition with x bigger than 20 can never be met, because it's basically a subset of conditions than x bigger than 10. Right? So x bigger than 10 includes obviously x bigger than 20 as well. Right? So let's try it with x is 25, and you will see that it won't print bigger than 20, right? So x is bigger than 20, but here x is bigger than 10, which is wrong, okay? So always make sure that the order is sensible and that the most constraining case is starting. And then you go to the wider and more general cases until you finally reach the else case, which is the default case by which everything is met. Okay. Now you may ask, how about the hook colon? Julian, you said that the hook colon and if and else, they basically lead to the same output. You can mimic the behavior of one using the other construct. How does this work? Yes, it works. So let's try now with the hook colon in our if case, hook colon for if else. Right, so far what we did in our hook colon, we said if x bigger than 10, then we print x is bigger than 10. Otherwise, we print x smaller than 10. Now we want to include and add another case. So how to do that? Well, we take the condition here that we had, x bigger than 20, as our initial condition. And then if this condition is met, well, we want to print x is bigger than 20. Let me copy and paste it. But if it's not met, now we know what could have happened is that x is actually bigger than 10. In this case, we want to print x is bigger than 10. Or x is smaller than 10, in which case we print x is smaller than 10. Right, so we added a nested condition. Let me intendate it slightly better. That you see how it works. So we have our first condition here, and if it's true, this is what happens. But if it's false, then this code is basically executed. So let me try it. We have the value still is 25. Now we should see the exact output that we like. The whole colon for our if else returns x is bigger than 20. Like expected. And believe me when I tell you that this code does what it should do. Let me show now one last equivalence. So here we have used the if and else construct. So we wanted to say, if this condition yields, then run this code. Otherwise, run basically that code. So it's totally easy to mimic this behavior using just the if construct and not using the else syntax. Let's try to do that. First of all, we say mimic if else using two if conditions. So let's try to do that. Let me copy, first of all, the initial condition, because that is makes sense, right? If x is bigger than 10, we always want to run this code. Now, if this condition is not held, we want to execute some other code. We did do that with using else. Now, what we can do instead, we can negate the condition here inside if, and by negating it, we will run this part of the code only if the condition is not met, right? So if this condition is met, run this code. If the condition is not met, well, the if over here will become true. And if it's true, we run the code over here. So let me copy part of the else. So if you think about it, that's a very straightforward way to replicating by replicating the condition and negating it, that we got the else branch. Either one of those two branches always will be executed, and it does exactly do what our else construct has done.